Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In the previous video we were doing problems on Bell Drive. I think we did three problems on Bell Drive. Now I am continuing that. I have taken problem number 13 again. This is in V belt. A compressor requiring 90 kilowatt is to run at about 250 rpm. P is 90 kilowatt, N is 250 rpm. The drive is by V belts from an electric motor running at 750 rpm. So I will call this as N1, N2, this is actually N2, this is N1. N1 is 750 rpm. The diameter of the pulley on the compressor shaft, that is D2 is 1 meter. The distance between the pulleys is limited to 1.75 meters. The belt speed should not exceed 1600 meters per minute. Determine the number of belts required, number of V belts required to transmit the power. If each belt has a cross sectional area of 375 square mm, cross sectional area is 375 mm square. Density is 1000 kg per cubic meter, and allowable stress of 2.5 MPa. Allowable stress is 2.5 megapascals. The groove angle is 35 degree. Alpha is 35 degree. The coefficient of friction is 0.25. Calculate the length of belt, length of each belt required. Okay. 0.25, mu is 0.25. He wants length also, and he wants the number also, number of belts also is required. Now the formula for power is P is equal to N into T1 minus TC, because this is given. What is given? This rho is given. Rho is given. So T1 minus TC into 1 minus 1 by e to the power of mu theta by sine of alpha by 2 into V divided by 1000. So many kilowatt. So from here we have to find out what N is to be found out. This is to be found out. To find out this, all other things must be required. Now T1 will be equal to F into area of cross section. You know, stress is load by area. So load is equal to stress into area. So T1 I will get. This I know. T1 will be equal to 2.5 multiplied by area. Area is 375. 2.5 into 375 will give me the 2.5 into 375 will give me 2.5 into 375 gives me 937.5 Newton. 37.5 Newton. I got this. So T1 I got. TC will be MV square. So V is given. So M we have to find out. M will be equal to rho into area in square meters here. So 1000 into area is given in millimeter square. So that is 375 divided by 1000 into 1000 to convert it into square per meter into square meters. Square mm to square meters. So this will go. So it will be 0.375 kg. This will be M. Now V is 1600 meters per minute. So it will be 1600 divided by 60. That is 26.67 meters per second. So now TC will be equal to MV square, that is 0.375 into V square, 26.67 square. This is there already. So square of answer multiplied by 0.375 will give me 266.67. 266.67 Newton. So I got this. I know this. I know mu. Mu also I know. Alpha also I know. But I don't know theta. So theta I have to find out. So what all things I got? T1 I have got as 937.5 Newton. I have got TC as 266.67 Newton. Next, I have to find out theta. Theta is equal to 180 minus 25. Theta is equal to 180 minus 25 degrees. So phi will be equal to R1 minus R2 divided by 2C. Sine inverse of that is sine inverse of R1 minus R2, the bigger of the two radius divided by 2C. So many degrees. So here D2 and N2, N1, D1 is not given. D1 will be equal to D2 N2 divided by N1. D1 is 1 meter. N1 is 750 divided by 250. That means this will be 3 meters. Half of that will be 1.5 meters. Sine inverse of 1.5 minus this dia is 1, that is 0.5, divided by 2 into C is 1.75. So this will be equal to, phi will be equal to, this will be 1 by 1 divided by 1 divided by 3.5 equals 0.285. Shift sign answer equals. So this will be 16.6 degrees. So this theta will be equal to 180 minus 2 into 16.6, so into 2 equals this much. 180 minus answer will give me 146.8 degrees, or it will be into pi divided by 180. That will be 2.56 radians, that is theta. So now I know everything. I know this, I know this, I know this, everything I know, I can get n. So p is 90, make a substitution. N I don't know, divided by 1000 into t1. T1 is 937.5 minus, this is 266.667 into 1 minus 1 by e to the power of mu. Mu is 0.25 into theta is 2.56. divided by sine of theta, alpha is alpha by 2, that is 35 by 2, that means it is 17 and a half, into v is 26.67 divided by 1000. So n will be equal to, what we want is n. I will first do this, simplify this. 90 into 1000, this 1000 I have taken this side, is equal to 937.5 minus 266.67 gives me 670.83. We have n there. N into 670.83 into this, we will simplify, 0.25 into 0.25 into 2.56 divided by sine of 17.5 equals 2.12. I am getting this e to the power of that, shift in, answer equals 8.4. I am getting this value, e to the power of this, I am getting 8.4. 1 by that means it is 0.119 something, 1 minus answer. So this whole thing I got as 0.88 into 26.67, I get that. So n will be equal to 90 into 1000 divided by 670.83 into 0.88 into 26.67. So how much do we get? 90 into 1000 divided by 670.83 divided by 0.88 divided by 26.67 will give me 5.71. We cannot have fractional number of belts, so say 6, next, round it up to next. This thing, 6 belts are necessary. 6 belts are necessary. Then, for finding length of each belt, it is open belt. So the formula is open belt drive. The formula is pi into R1 plus R2 plus 2C plus R1 minus R2 the whole square divided by 2C. This is the formula. You substitute the values. R1, one radius is 1.5. The other one is 0.5 meters. They are all in meters. 2 into 1.75 plus R1. R1 is 1.5 minus 0.5. The whole square divided by 2 into 1.75. If you do simplify that, you will get it in meters, because we have put everything in meters. 1 divided by 3.5 plus 3.5 plus 2 into pi. That will give me 10.07 meters roughly. So this is the length of each belt. So this is how that problem is to be done. Next, we will take up the problem, one more problem on rope drive. Pascal. Okay, friends, next I have taken problem number 15. This is from rope drive. A pulley used to transmit power by means of ropes has a diameter of 3.6 meter. The dia of the pulley is 3.6 meters and has 15 grooves. That means we can put 15 ropes. If there are 15 grooves, we can put 15 ropes maximum. Grooves of 45 degree angle, that is alpha is 45 degree. The angle of contact is 170 degree, that is theta is 170 degree. And the coefficient of friction is 0.28, mu is 0.28. The maximum per possible tension in the rope is, that is T1, tension on tight side, cannot be more than 960 newton. Then the mass of rope is, this is M, 1.5 kg per meter length, so it is M directly given. Calculate the speed of the pulley. Calculate the speed of the pulley in RPM. What is N? What is N? And the power transmitted. If the condition of maximum power prevails, the condition of maximum power prevails. Right. This is the problem. Now, first what we will do is, for maximum power, what is the condition? We know that TC must be equal to T1 by 3. So T1 is 960 divided by 3. So it will be 320 newton, 320 newton, one third of 960, T1 by 3. Then we know TC is equal to MV square. I know TC, mass is given here, mass of the rope is given, so I can get V. So V will be equal to TC divided by M under root. So this will be root of 320 divided by M is 1.5. under root. So take your calculator, 320 divided by 1.5 equals 213 point something, 213.3 root of that. square root of answer is 14.6. 14.6 meter per second. This is V. Then V we know is pi d n by 60. So n will be equal to 60 into V divided by pi d. That is 60 into 14.6 divided by pi into d is given as 3.6 meters. 3.6 meters. 14.6 into 60 divided by pi divided by 3.6 equals 77.5 approximately. 77.5 RPM. This is the speed of the pulley in RPM. So I got one of these. One of these I got. Next, he wants power. Power will be maximum power, that is N into T1 minus TC into 1 minus 1 by e to the power of mu theta by sine of alpha by 2 whole thing multiplied by V divided by 1000. So many kilowatts. So make a substitution now. Let us substitute the values. That's the formula. We know everything there. We know everything. So P will be equal to N. N is 15. We can accommodate maximum 15 ropes. T1 is given 960 minus TC is 320 into 1 minus 1 by e to the power of mu 0.28. Theta is in degrees, so 170 into pi by 180. 170 into pi divided by 180 will give me 2.967 radians. So this will be 2.967 divided by sine of 45 by 2, alpha is 45, so 22.5 degree. This whole thing into V is 16.6 divided by 1000. This is the power, maximum power that we can get. So now this is 15 into this works out to 640 into this is, I'll work out, 0.28 into 2.967 divided by sine 22.5 equals, this works out to 2.17 e to the power of that I want, so shift in answer equals 8.76. I got this value of e to the power of this. Now 1 by this x to the power of minus 1, if you press equals, you will get 1 by that. Then we have to subtract this whatever we got here from 1. So 1 minus answer will give you 0.885 into 16.6 divided by 1000. So this I have got into 16.6 into 640 into 15 divided by 1000 will give me power of 141.2 kilowatts. This is the power, that maximum power which can be transmitted using that. So I got this also. So that finishes the problem. I once again request you to subscribe my channel.